Hey everybody, how you doing out there? It's your show. I'm doing a podcast live. This is a stereo sounding podcast. This is a very special podcast. This topic has to do with, you may have heard about him on InfoWars. It's not Alex Jones. It's not David McKnight, which you all know about him. He's an older guy, older in terms of 60, 70 years old. He is a family guy. He's married, and that's not the person I'm talking about. This other person, the third person of the InfoWars studio, you may have heard about him several times on that on the InfoWars studio. He goes by the name Owen Shroyer. And he's the youngest, I kid you not, the youngest guy in the InfoWars studio. Three people are on that studio. Alex Jones, you got your Alex Jones of the world. You might have heard about him. David McKnight, as he's known to. And Owen Shroyer, he's the third guy. He's in the war room. This is a sort of a war room. It's the third channel of the InfoWars studio. But originally with the main channel on the InfoWars channel, I like to say like everybody else would say it. On the main channel on InfoWars, originally Alex Jones does the main channel. That's the InfoWars studio. That's the main channel. They have a program, video program, where he's talking about everything under the sun. It's not really ranting. It's like commentary stuff. You might have seen him on InfoWars. Just type in InfoWars.com. You'll see him there. He's on the main channel. Alex Jones on the main channel. Two other channels that website has is David McKnight. Sometimes I hear him a couple times. He's not bad. He's an older guy, but he's not bad. Then you got Owen Shroyer. He's kind of like the younger version of Alex Jones. The younger version, if you know what I mean. He's kind of like the younger guy version of Alex Jones, in a way. He's kind of like the younger guy in the whole InfoWars thing. But he does the war room, and he got arrested. Not only that, he got arrested several times, folks. This is not just first time he got arrested. He got arrested for many reasons, and this is coming from the state side. Not from the Canadian side of things, where you have the charter rights. In the United States, you'll have what you call amendments in the Constitution, to your civil rights, to your everything under the sun, in terms of if you be an American citizen. American citizens, if you live in residency in the United States for 5 or 10 years, you're considered American. Yeah. And yes, that's what the Americans come to believe. If you they don't do the swearing in, they just do like the Canadians do. They when you come to Canada, you're kind of like swearing in, and kind of like doing the swearing in. So they greet you as being a first Canadian, and you come to this and you got your citizenship, and people do have this dual citizenship from the Canadian side of things to the American side of things. So dual citizenship. And if you go over to the United States, you've got so-called Joe Biden to deal with. Well, he's the head honcho of the entire United States. He's the President of the United States currently, if you're wondering who the current President of the United States is. And all you kids should know that. Is Joe Biden along with Kamala Harris? Yes, the first woman as vice president. I'm not joking, folks. Kamala Harris, her mother and her dad must be happy about all that. In her position that she is in. So she's helping out. She's vice president. She's should be next in line to be president of the United States if she plays her cards right. But yeah, have you just seen her in full form? Kamala Harris might be the next president of the United States in the next 4 years. We don't know. But until then, we want to talk about Owen Shroyer. Let's go back to Owen Shroyer for a sec. He's a great guy. He's an amazing guy. Amazing, amazing guy. You should go check him out. He does shows, and sometimes on Fridays he'll do all the veterans out there, all the veterans. They take time, I think, either end of the month or before the month. They take calls on veterans. This is all Veterans Day. And they take calls for veterans. Anybody who's a veteran from the wars, from the 40s onward, or currently now into battle these days in the and other parts of the countries, they'll devolve themselves for four hours of veterans. These are veterans who have fought the good wars, still is in this day and age, if they still are, from the 40s onward. They're going to devote 4 hours, one day, 4 hours of Veterans Day, or we call it the VA. They call it VA Veterans Affairs. So, folks, we're going to talk about Owen Shroyer in depth. He's a great guy. He's a younger version of Alex Jones, as I would say. The younger version, he's a predecessor as Alex Jones. Alex Jones is just kind of like he's the on the main page. That steers the ship of InfoWars. He's got two friends there, and I appreciate Owen Shroyer a lot. I keep forgetting that he's always been there for a while. I kind of tapered off on InfoWars for a while. And just the other day, I was watching his videos, and I was just saying to myself, well, let's take this guy seriously. Maybe in the year 2024, he'll become the next president of the United States. And God forbid he will. We'll give kudos where kudos are due. He's kind of like this Alex Jones. He's a younger version, and he does the war room, and the special kind of war room. It's not like any other war room. And this is what we're going to do. We're going to pronounce his name, and if you don't know what I'm saying, I'll put his name on the subtitles when I'm getting it in this podcast. So be well aware, this guy is a younger version of Alex Jones, younger version of him. And he's pretty good. He's gone out to create that comments that you would come to believe. There's a lot of criticism along the way. And he's fed up. Like I said, everybody's fed up in this so-called politician stuff. And we're all fed up to yin-yang, you know? And he was just frustrated beyond belief. But yeah, in politics world, you get very frustrated over the situation of the politics, where it doesn't sway your way to the politicians of the world. You know, when they vote people in, they're supposed to get the right person voted in. And not always the case. Not always the case. If you don't like Joe Biden, that's their prerogative. And people do like Donald Trump. People swear up and down that Donald Trump was the greatest president of the United States. I still harp on that situation where Donald Trump was great. When you look back on it, you think about it, he was the greatest president of the United States. Not because a lot of people don't like him or anything, and Sergeant, whatever the people have said about Donald Trump, what he's not, I think he did a good job over those 4 years. He did a really good job considering what the people have called him bad names to, you know, misogyny and all this nasty words. But like I said, same as you think about Donald Trump, I think he was the really good president of the United States. I still harbor on that. Because, you know, I think Joe Biden does not know what he's saying half the time. And whereas Donald Trump, he was right on the ball. He asks the media questions and answers. He does a Q&A with the media, in which I appreciate that, you know. And whereas Joe Biden, he just disregards the media answering questions. People do it differently in the world. They kind of tell you like it is, and they don't ask questions and answers. They do it their own way of doing things. And for a while there, I was just kind of disregard. This is so like Joe Biden did not answer questions and answers and stuff. When I see his press comments, he doesn't do questions and answers to the media or the TV stations. So I think this is a different way of Joe Biden handling it. And he's trying to deal with the COVID-19 and the way that he's dealing with it. Anyway, I'm going to stop my ranting. This will be my title of this video. And you'll get to see it in the near distant podcast, yes, if you want to call it like that. And just listen to my podcast. I'm going to put it in stereo sounding podcast. And make it sound, I'm going to do with the EQs. I'm going to do with the gain volumes, turn up the gains in the input levels, and make it sound really good. And most importantly, make it sound and pitch my voice, and definitely pitch my voice. So I'm going to do all those things that you guys will appreciate. Here we go. Until then, I'll see you guys on the next podcast. Until then.